Google Ads budget optimization. As a business owner, Shopify store owner, CMO, any business leader, you don't need to be hands-on with Google Ads, but you need to give your Google Ads direction on how to optimize your budget for optimal results. So let's start with a story. A few years ago, I was hired by a CEO. The CEO was wasting money on Google Ads and he didn't know what was going on, but he just had the gut feeling that, okay, he needs to stop wasting money on Google Ads. And when he hired me, he was like, okay, Femi, help me out here. So the first thing I did was have a conversation with the Google Ads agency. So I spoke to them, tried to understand the campaign setup, and then I spoke to the business as well. And from that conversation, I realized that the definition of conversion for the Google Ads agency was different to what the business understood and valued as conversion. The Google Ads agency was just funneling traffic to the website and they felt that's their bit. So to them, that was conversion. But this was a insurance organization. So it was more like getting people to the website to subscribe for insurance and policies and things like that. So the first thing we did was look at the keywords that they were targeting, and we realized that, okay, they're targeting two broad keywords that were just bringing a lot of traffic, and those traffic were not necessarily converting. So we worked with the Google Ads agency and the in-house team. We defined what conversion was. Conversion to them, to the CEO, was people actually buying a policy, not just landing on the website, actually going through the whole journey. So that was the first thing we did. So what I'm trying to say here, for you to get the best of your Google Ads optimization, you first need to understand that, okay, what conversions are you targeting? And are they really the money value conversions that you should be targeting? So the next thing we did was having conversations with SEO, email marketing, to kind of understand that, okay, how do all this work hand in hand? Because Google Ads by itself would bring traffic, but you don't want to be bringing traffic every time to the website through Google Ads. So we used email marketing to kind of optimize those campaigns. In Google Ads, you always have keywords that have very high search volumes. You have keywords that are long tail keywords, and then you have keywords that just bring just traffic that are not really ready to buy immediately. It takes a bit of warming up for them to buy. So your strategy needs to pay less attention to those very high volume keywords and pay more attention to like high converting, high intent keyword. But the way Google Ads works is you just cannot get only quality traffic. You are going to get bad traffic and good traffic. So it's left to you to continuously optimize, because it takes about 60 to 90 days for Google Ads to understand, okay, this is what good looks like. So you need to kind of also optimize your ad copy. So part of what I did with the CEO back then was sat down with him, look at the website funnel. After Google Ads brings traffic, look at the funnel, what happens to the traffic after that. And we realized there was a lot of conversion friction points and a lot of drop-off points. We streamlined those funnels. They say use the funnel now. That's about 7 or 8 years ago, and they still use that funnel in that company. The CEO is even not there anymore. But my point is making sure that your ad copy, number one, just does not allow unqualified leads. So as a business owner, a business leader, a CMO, you need to actually sometimes look at, okay, what is the ad copy doing? Are they communicating specific information that kind of communicates to the type of audience you want? And you also want to make sure that your ad copy is filtering out the bad leads that you don't want. So this is where a very, very good Google Ads expert or a good Google Ads agency would write a copy on your Google Ads, and a CRO, a conversion rate optimization person, will look at those copy and will help optimize it in a psychological way to kind of communicate more of a emotional branding on your ad copy. So the quality of your ad copy, if it's just written generically as a standard copy, it will not get the kind of result that you want. You want your ad copy to discourage clicks from unqualified leads and encourage clicks from the people that are your target audience. Also, you want to pay attention to the landing page. Part of what I did with the CEO to optimize his Google ad budgets was look at all the landing page where we were bringing people to, did landing page optimization on that. The goal was not necessarily to increase quality score. The goal was to make sure that when people land on there, they start that conversion funnel. We're able to quickly capture their email. So even if they don't complete the whole journey, when we capture their email, we then use email marketing to use that as retargeting rather than using retargeting in itself. So what I would recommend if you're looking to get the best of your Google ad budget is to make sure that you just don't focus on metrics that are more metrics that don't really matter. You just need one metric. That metric is conversion. And another thing we did there is also to get the best quality from the Google ad is we made sure that the customers that have converted, because it was an insurance product, we knew that, okay, it would take 12 months before they renew. So there was also a plan in place that, okay, after the 12 months, we set up email sequence to, okay, nudge them back even before the expiration of their policy. So like, okay, your policy will soon be expiring and we kind of make sure that we reduce churn. So optimizing your Google ad budget as a business owner, a CMO, you don't have to go into your Google ads and do the manual bidding and things like that. But you want to request for visibility at a top level of the kind of ad copy that is used to send traffic to your website. You also want to look at the landing page. You want to look at the funnels. So it's not just about managing bids. It's just making sure that you understand clearly the conversion goal. Sometimes that macro conversion goal, it's not going to happen immediately. You set up campaigns to at least take people to the first step, which is getting them to your website, and then CRO working in synergy with Google Ads is the best way to optimize your Google Ads. If you need help with your Google Ads optimization, reach out to me. I'll be happy to help you. Connect with me on LinkedIn as well and drop me a note for one-to-one consultation. The agency I work for will be glad and will be able to help you. Thank you.